Alzheimer's, and she's from Arizona. So she didn't have a valid California state license to walk in and renew a license. They made her go through all these hoops just to get another driver's license, where once again, if you're an illegal, all you have to do is walk into DMV and state you're undocumented, and they'll immediately...
You know how many emails I get every day from white women who are being intimidated in these DMVs by illegal aliens who glower at them? They stare at them, they glower at them, they intimidate them. They're trying to chase them out of the Motor Vehicle Bureau with their hatred. I get this all the time, and no one ever talks about it. You know, there's a lot of crime, and there's a lot of subsurface violence. You know, you want to call microviolence? There's a lot of microviolence being committed by the illegal aliens towards the indigenous population, and this has to be reported. And we hear about white privilege. How about illegal privilege? Aren't you now talking about illegal alien privilege?
Well, it's also like there's no such thing as reverse racism. You know, I take sociology classes here at Sac State, and my professors continuously speak in class about how there's no such thing as reverse racism. It's a
Well, what you say to them is, excuse me, racism is racism no matter where it comes from. But we're talking now about the armies of illegal aliens who have been led in by Governor Brown and the machine that runs the state in order to keep them in power. And we're talking now about the consequences of that in the form of the homeless people who are not given as many services as the illegals. Isn't that, do you agree with me that that's tied in? That so much money is going to the illegals that a lot of it isn't getting over to the people in this country who are at the bottom like the bums?
Yes, it's to win votes. If you bring in enough illegal aliens who support the socialism of America, give it a few more years, and we will no longer have a conservative Republican vote. I've heard it in my class alone. My teacher since 2008 has been preaching, Obama, Obama, Hillary, Hillary, no more Republicans. And I mean, this is actively taught in schools and colleges in one of the most populated cities in California. Now,
well, we know about the professors. We know who they are. They've never worked for a living because they don't have the capacity to get real jobs. So instead, they brainwash the young who have no way to fight back. And now we have a television network, Punivision, sending one of their loudmouths here to try and take Donald Trump down. But Punivision wasn't too happy when their anchor got thrown out on his behind for ranting and raving like a madman. Jeffrey, thanks for listening to the Savage Nation. But I still don't see the problem. Put them in the bug houses, number one. Number two, clean them up and make them take the menial jobs. That would help a lot. I think that would help a lot. Let's look at some of the other news that's on the various websites. Again, I can't tell you the graphic footage from InfoWars. The complete video shot from the Virginia killer's point of view is heartbreaking to watch this woman being executed by this maniac. A killer who was fired after fabricating claims of racism goes back and kills this woman and the newsman, just shoots them point blank. And if you want to watch a sick thing like that, go ahead. Or if you got the heart to look at the San Francisco bum defecating openly in the street like a dog, go ahead, look at that. How to solve San Francisco's homeless problem? Well, there's no solutions in the newspaper. They come up with always a joke. Everything to them is a joke, a giddy little solution to everything. But the fact of the matter is, this city is going downhill very fast. The aggressiveness of the bums, the filth of the bums needs to be stopped. Apparently Super Bowl 50 is coming, and the city fathers, so to speak, are getting a little nervous about the bum problem. What they're actually going to do is another story. What is the alternative? What is the mayor proposing as an alternative? We don't know the answer, but the fact of the matter is the health issues themselves should dictate a solution. What would you do to get rid of the bum problem in San Francisco? KSFO Victor, you live in this area. What would you do?
I just wanted to stand on the last caller. They say it's unrealistic to support all these illegals, and I say you wouldn't have to support them all. Start removing all their benefits, and not just their social benefits, but their benefits to find employment, their benefits to open a bank account, their benefits to rent and buy homes, etc. All of this stuff is not illegal to illegal immigrants of this country. And one more side note about the wall. You know, forgive me for being logical about this, Mr. Savage, but, you know, we can't build a wall, right? We can launch a rocket into space to intercept an object millions of miles away, but we can't build a wall? Come on now.
No, a wall is very easy to build. The Israelis did it, and the suicide bombings have come to near zero. Once they kept the Palestinian terrorists on their side of the wall. There's no question that if the Israelis can do it, we can do it. And they say, well, it's how many miles it is. So what? What does the length have to do with it? We have the resources. We can use the resources to build a wall. I agree with you. That would help an awful lot. Yes, build the wall, Donald Trump. Go and build the wall. It's that simple. Let's go to the solution on the bum things. Let's see. WABC, Robert, what's your solution to the bum problem?
Yes, sir. I think we should reinstitute the WPA, the CCC, put them all in the old closed military camps, room and board, medical care, give them vocational training at night, and in the daytimes, have them go out and do laborer work in the agricultural, the infrastructure, the forest to stop all the fires.
Well, that's true. That's who used to do this. The people on the bottom who couldn't do anything else did these kind of jobs. Now, because we have basically an easy ride, you know, with a welfare state, they'd rather stay home and smoke crack.
Yes, but if they won't go into the camps to be reeducated, learn the work, and live like decent people, then you put them in the crazy houses because you have to be crazy to not take that over living in the streets.
Oh, okay, so what you're saying is you have a two-tier solution. You start the government WPA and CCC camps, which I'm very familiar with, because believe it or not, some of my father's friends actually worked in the CCC camps, which I can talk about at some length. There were no paradises there, I can guarantee you that. That was really hard work. Are you an older guy?
Yes, sir. But my grandfather was in the CCC, and he told me stories about it. And he goes, it's the best thing that ever happened to me. And after the war ended, he finished his life as a park ranger until he retired.
Yeah, and my father's friend went in the CCC. He was a rough kid from the streets of New York. Those were the Civilian Conservation Corps. And he said that they did exactly what you're talking about. He said, we shoveled for 8 hours straight. He said, you have no idea what muscles you'll discover in your body when you're moving a shovel all day long digging ditches or cutting down trees in a forest. You find out how you're actually built after that, and you come home harder than you will from working out in a gym for an hour a day. Kind of eliminate the need for a gym if you worked in the CCC camp. All right, that's something to think about. No one's thinking about it. This is the Savage Nation. I'll be right back.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
Your Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com. It's the only company I trust for tangible assets, gold and silver. Call 800-BUY-COIN. Ladies and gentlemen. All right, a little more information is coming out about that so-called reporter who shot and killed two former co-workers on live TV. They say in the Fox News that he was a gay black man, a murderer filled with anger. He was feared in the newsroom. He threatened everybody, and he sent the manifesto of anger. He was well known as a troublemaker and a bully, and it's all on FoxNews.com. There you go. Poor girl is dead, and the poor guy is dead. He killed him in cold blood. And that's it. That's what's going on under the surface in America. A nation of rage, because it's man against woman, race against race. It's unbelievable what this man has provoked in this country. He has so divided this nation. It is a more hateful place than I've ever seen in my lifetime as a result of this wonderful man from a man filled with hope and change. Well, here's the hope and the change. I guess he's gotten exactly what he wanted, the transformation of a nation that was already rocky to one that's almost crumbling. Let's pray to God we survive what's left of this regime's time in the White House, and that we get Donald Trump to try to clean up the rubble. I don't know if anyone could clean up the rubble after what this guy is doing, and God knows what he's going to do next. All right, let's go on to the callers. Line 6, on which topic and what's your solution to this issue? Go ahead, please.
Oh, well, I'm not calling with a solution. I was just calling with an article that appeared on SF Weekly. Mayor Lee tells the homeless to leave during the Super Bowl. Isn't one to let human rights get in the way of a dollar. As his latest tone-deaf remarks on the...
Wait a minute. He's telling the homeless to leave when the Super Bowl comes to town. Well, this is not unprecedented. Dianne Feinstein chased the homeless out of San Francisco when she was mayor. Do you know that? I remember it. It was a laughing line at the time. the DNC, the Democrat National Committee, was coming to town. Feinstein was mayor. She paved the streets from the airport to the downtown where they were going to meet, and she got rid of all the homeless for that week that they were in town. Do you know that? This is how fascists operate. This is what they do. This is what they do, and then they go back to their normal ways. So this is nothing new. Where are they going to move the homeless to, though? Where are they going to send them up to Lake County? Where are they going?
Well, he doesn't say. He just says, we'll give you an alternative. We're always going to be supportive, but you'll have to leave the streets. So,
but where do they go? Where are they going to move them to? Sonoma Square?
Are they going
to bring them to the Marin County Civic Center grounds? They could pitch tents for them there. After all, that's in Diane, that's in Barbara Boxer's backyard, and I'm sure that she would welcome them in her county of Marin. And all of the other good liberals in Marin who read the San Francisco newspapers, though it's the Holy Grail, I'm sure that they would welcome in their own homes. I think that they should put out a call for all of the good white people in Marin to open their homes up, their empty nests, to the homeless for a couple of weeks during the Super Bowl. Wouldn't that work?
That's a solution, yeah. Bob.
Yeah, solution is right there. All of the good liberals who are so very, very good should open their homes up to the homeless for a few weeks. Let's see how that works out. But let's get serious here. What would you do to end the homeless bum? I don't know. It's a problem in all American cities, but it's the worst in San Francisco. They're brazen, defecating in the streets, urinating in the streets, aggressive panhandling. What would you do to end this scourge in this city? It stinks so badly I ran out of the city on Sunday, 30 minutes after getting into town. That's how bad it is.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282. Savage.
All I can say is if you come to San Francisco, don't come with a flower in your hair. Come with galoshes and a raincoat. Even if it's dry out, you're going to need it to wade through the piles of urine and defecation being left by the sacred homeless, the equivalent of our untouchables in this liberal city on the bay. What started out as well-meaning by the American Psychiatric Association has turned into a scourge upon civilized society, and there needs to be solutions. And as I've said from the outset of this discussion, the solutions range from build them all a house to put them into a mental hospital. And the fact of the matter is, there's a little truth in all of it. But no, what, you want to build them a house? Have you seen what they do to the quarters they are given to live in? Has anyone ever looked at what they do to the places they're given to live in? Are they livable? Are they habitable? No, they're not. They don't take care of them. Usually if someone is given something for nothing, they don't take care of it. Whether it's a housing project where we have tens of millions of American citizens doing nothing. Nothing, just sitting, existing. Take a look at Baltimore, what the housing projects gave us. So we have a disease in America. It's a philosophical disease of ultra-tolerance. You thought I was going to say liberalism, but I didn't. Ultra-tolerance is killing us. Let's stop using the word liberal and liberalism because we all have heard it so many times we're immune to it. It's the word, the phrase ultra-tolerance is killing us, which I used in 1994. And that's why a small man from Puny Vision can come to America and try to step on the only candidate worth listening to, Donald Trump. Jorge Ramos, George Ramos, whatever his name is, works for a television show called Puny Vision, a station, a network owned by NBC, I guess. I don't know who owns who. But Puny Vision sends this guy, this thug, this bully into America and tries to run our country for us. George Ramos from Puny Vision wants to come here and bully him off the stage. Well, it didn't work. Because he figured his minions are the armies. Behind them, everyone would cater to them. Like the Democrats, you know, every day they tell us, the Hispanic vote this, the Hispanic vote that. Well, that's fine. That's well and good. But there are other votes in America, like the African-American vote, those who work for a living in the white community, the Caucasian vote. How about the Asian-American vote? Why does no one ever talk about the Asian-American vote? What, they're already dismissed, that they don't count? So let's not overestimate the Hispanic vote, number one. And number two, I'll tell you something else about it. I predicted this weeks ago, and it was long before anybody else said it would happen, and the data has proven it. The Hispanics love Donald Trump. They want a strong leader. Let me put it to you this way. Use common sense. Try to not think through the rose-colored glasses that you were taught to wear in college. Let's say you come into a country that's so stupid that it lets you walk right over its border, a nation